So guys, good morning once again. We stopped in the last class here. I said that program counter is responsible for holding the address of the next instruction, whereas MAR will be getting the address of the next instruction, that is the instruction which we are going to execute right now. Once MAR will get that particular address, the external data bus will be opened. The external data bus will be opened, that means that particular instruction will be fetched from the memory to the CPU. In CPU, we are having a special purpose register IR. IR is dedicated for holding the instruction which is being fetched from the memory. And in IR, the IR will contain the memory element of the address which is being stored in the MAR, that is the instruction itself. So, the particular instruction is now stored in the IR. Along with this, in the same machine state, the program counter will be incremented by 1. Why? The program counter will be incremented by 1 so that it can hold the next instructions address. That is, the program counter is ready for the next instruction right now. After that, the instruction which is being held in the IR, that is the instruction which we are going to execute right now, that will be now decoded. Decoding will be done with the help of the decoder. So, the decoder will get the particular instruction. Along with that, at the same time, in the same machine state, here I mentioned that this T0, T1 and T2 is known as the machine states. All of these are known as the machine states. So, here what will happen? The least significant 12 bits, that is the bits of the operational field, those will be now stored in the MAR. Why? I told that in this particular case, the result of the decoder may be twofold. One, it may be a register reference instruction or it may be a memory reference instruction. What if it is a register reference instruction? If it is a register reference instruction, that is the opcode is 111, if you can remember. If it is 111, that means that is a register reference instruction. But in that register reference instruction, again we were having 9 different types of instruction. For that 9 different types of instruction, we have to look into the least significant 12 bits of the IR, where we will get the unique bit pattern which we have discussed in the last class, the unique bit pattern for all the instructions. But if it is a memory reference instruction, in that case, in the least significant 12 bits, what we will get? We will get the address of the particular instruction, the particular memory reference instruction, suppose it is a memory read operation or memory write operation. So, from which particular location we have to read or in which particular location we have to write, that details, that memory address is now given here. Now, as you can understand that, it is a particular memory element we have to access, then we must use the external data bus. And what is the condition for using the external data bus? It is nothing but the MAR must have the value of that particular address. The MAR must get the particular address. Here we are performing this operation just to ensure that if by chance after decoding we get that the instruction is a memory reference instruction, we don't need to waste another machine state for just doing this thing. Rather, here the decoder is fed with the first 4 bits or the opcode and the rest operational field is fed to the MAR. Right? Now, we have to proceed further. Now, look into it. Till this, it does not mean what instruction you are going to execute. This step is same. What we have done yet? We have fetched the operand, that is the opcode fetch cycle. and the decoding, that is taken care of here. But once the decoding is done, what we have to do? We have to now perform the micro operations depending upon the particular instruction, because only after decoding we can understand which particular instruction we have to perform. For example, you can remember that we have jotted down in the last class, that is add R1, complement, AND R1, move R1, R2, move R2, R1, move R1, accumulator, move accumulator, R1, move R2, accumulator, move accumulator, R2. These were the register reference instruction, and for memory reference instruction there was move accumulator, memory, move memory, accumulator, and jump. Right. So we will look into it in details. We will study this thing in very details, because here we are trying to design the CPU. I hope you can understand the importance. Being a computer engineer, in your whole lifetime you are going to work with the CPU, the computer, but you must know how we can design the CPU. To understand the designing principle of any CPU, you have to grab this thing very properly. That is why we will discuss the whole thing here in minute detailing. So here let us assume that after decoding we get that this is nothing but add operation. So for once let us assume that we are facing the challenge add R1. I told you that add R1 means what? Add R1 means accumulator is equals to accumulator plus R1. I told you earlier, accumulator equals to accumulator plus R1. Now if I just taken you back, this was the ALU, this was the accumulator, and this was R1 and R2. Can you remember? This was the internal data path. Here you can see, for this addition, for this particular addition operation which will be done in the ALU, one operand is present in the accumulator, other one is present in the R1. But R1 is not connected with ALU. But ALU is connected with only accumulator and data register. So use your simple brain. We have to copy the content of R1 to data register for giving access to the ALU. That means here what we have to do in the very beginning, we have to confirm that the content of R1 is copied to data register so that ALU can access that particular variable or the operand. And you can understand that will be performed during the machine state T3. That will perform during the machine state T3. Fine. Now, now you can understand that this R1 is now data register. So during T4, what will be our job? The output will be stored in accumulator. The output will be stored in accumulator. So here it will be like accumulator is equals to, accumulator is equals to what? I have told you that here we will be having IR, then we will be having the decoder, and then we will be having the timing and control unit. The timing and control unit will give control signal to all the components, to all the components after the decoding. So after decoding, we have received, it is add R1, it is add R1. So then timing and control unit will be providing the control signal to all the components accordingly. Here it will provide the signal to the ALU and signal will be add. To add whom? Accumulator and data register. ALU will get a particular control signal add to add the two operands. One is present in accumulator, other one is present in the data register. This is the whole thing. These three steps are common for all the instruction. This is not instruction specific, but T2 onwards, once the decoding is done, now the particular micro operations are instruction specific. In this particular case, you can understand that for add R1, we did these two micro operations, fine, but here we have to perform another thing. I hope you can understand that any software is not that short that only one add R1 operation is good enough to complete it. So what will happen? We have to perform instructions after instructions to complete a program. So only one instruction is not enough. So we have to perform some other instructions just immediate after the completion of this. If we want to perform another instruction, we have to follow the particular steps. That is, again instruction will be fetched, then again it will be decoded, and then again it will be executed, fine. So for instruction fetch, you know that this particular step is the first thing. So if I want to perform another instruction execution immediate after this execution, we have to go to this particular state. So we have to initiate state T0 after the completion of the particular instruction once. So what will happen? We have to initiate T0 here so that the control goes back here, and again the incremented value of program counter now move to MAR, and MAR now can just open the door for the external data bus using which the particular instruction is now fetched from the memory and stored in the IR. Then again the program counter will be incremented and that particular instruction will be decoded using the decoder, and the whole thing will repeat accordingly. So this was the step for performing add R1. Now let us consider what will happen during complement.